Hey, in this video, I will show you how you can build your own dynamic array in C. And what a dynamic array is I mean, you've probably already used it in a more high-level languages such as C++ or Python. In C++, they're called vectors. In Python, they're called lists. In Rust, vector again. In GoLang, they are slices, and so on and so on. So what a dynamic array is an array in memory that you can dynamically resize. So if you add an element to it or want to add an element to it and it doesn't have enough capacity to hold that element, it will automatically reallocate the array in a smart way to be able to fit that new element in. And the way it works is actually quite nice because, as you can see in this nice representation on Wikipedia, so you add the first element and then it has still enough space to add the second one. So the second one does not require a new allocation, but then you want to add the third one, so the one here, and then you have to actually reallocate the new array and copy the previous array in that new array. So that's why it has a little turtle and it means it's slow. But you can see still that it doesn't reallocate the whole array plus one element. It reallocates two places because it assumes that in the future you're going to want to use it more, and so it plans for the future in a sense, in because it allocates more memory than it needs to. And so here you can see a fourth element, still enough space, so it's speedy. But then here we run out of space for the fifth one. It redoes an allocation, but here you can see that it does an even larger allocation because it assumes that the more you use something, the more you will want to use it. So it's kind of an exponential growth. And so the actual size of the array is called the logical size here. So literally the number of elements. And the actual capacity of the array is the physical size or capacity. In my case, I will call them just length and capacity. So let me show you how I implemented this. I implemented this on stream just a few hours ago. And so I'm just gonna walk through it with you rather briefly. So here I just have a simple main.c file, and on the next page I have my implementation that I did on stream. So let me first of all copy paste the struct that I will use. So it's a struct called dynamic array, which, as I said, holds a capacity, a length, and the actual fixed array, which we're gonna resize or reallocate if we need to. So first of all, some very simple functions to make a new array and destroy it. So as you can see, it's rather simple. It mallocs a new struct of dynamic array. Set the capacity length to zero, the actual array to null, and destroys free the array if it exists, and free the struct. So that way we can actually create a dynamic array. So dynamic array new, like so, and dynamic array destroy of DA. Like so, and if I run this, it works, but of course we don't see anything. Next, we will want the dynamic array resize, which is actually rather simple as well, just to resize the array. So this will not change like the length or the elements of the array. It will just allocate a new chunk of memory for the required capacity and copy the element of the current array to that location. And in our case, realloc does that for us. And if you're wondering, for the first allocation, so the pointer is null, but if you give a null pointer as the first argument of realloc, it's basically exactly the same as malloc. So that's why it works. So here you can see we set the capacity to the new capacity and realloc the array. So here we can do it if we want to resize DA to a size of 10, for example. And yeah, Still, we don't see anything yet. I mean, we could just printf just the DA capacity to show that the capacity has changed from 0 to 10. Next, we want the actual growth function, which will, it's the function that we use to determine the amount of extra capacity that we need whenever we add a new element. So you know, remember I said like when we add one element and we don't have enough capacity, we don't want to allocate just one more of that element. We want to allocate like, I don't know, maybe 5 more, maybe 10 more. But how do we know that? We just have a growth factor. So we take the current capacity of the array and we multiply it by the growth factor, in this case 2. So we will start with an array of capacity 1. Then next time we want to reallocate, we will have capacity of 2, then capacity of 4, then 8, then 16, and all the powers of 2. So it exponentially grows the capacity of the array. And if you want to know how I got this magic number of a growth factor, just know that here is, for example, a list. So that, for example, in Java, they have a growth factor of like 1.5. In Python, they have this weird computation where they do a right shift for some reason. But like you can see that most of those is just like 1.5 or 2. Like, for example, Go, like Nim or Rust is 2 as well. So just an easy value for me in this example is 2, and it's also what professional languages use, so we can easily use that. And so that's the function to grow the array. So you can see, yeah, we just set the capacity to 1 if it's empty, and otherwise we just resize by multiplying the capacity by growth factor. That's all it does. And finally, the interesting parts. So the dynamic array push, so that's when we want to push a new element to the array, and so you see that all this does is so this is the equivalent of a C++ vector push or a pushback, I think, or Python's append on list, and so on and so on. And so you can see that here we just check if the length is already equal to the capacity. So if we don't have more room for an element, we grow the dynamic array. So we grow it to the capacity times 2 every time. Otherwise, we just don't do an allocation. And then we just put the element at the end of the array and increase the length. And yeah, that's it. So let's see this in action. So yeah, let's forget about the resize. Capacity is equal to this. Let's just quickly print the length and capacity of a dynamic array. And what I will want to do is do a dynamic array push and then DA. And let's say I want to push the number 42 there. Then I will print the length again, and then I will print push a bunch of elements. Let's make them slightly different, just to distinguish between them. Invalid next size. All right, small bug that I just discovered. Doing my implementation previously, I forgot to realloc with size of int. Since, of course, it's an array of int, and I was just treating it as an array of bytes because, yeah, just attention error and not enough testing. So, yeah, now I'm correctly reallocating it, and it works. So, oops, as you can see, if I do this, you can see that at the beginning it has a length of 0, capacity 0. Then we push one element, and the length is 1, capacity is 2. And let's print this length randomly here and randomly at the end as well. And as you can see, the array length just grows, but the capacity of it grows exponentially. So first it's 2, then it's 8, then it's 16, and so on and so on and so on. So yeah, that's what we want, and it's great. And the more you add element, it will this will always work. This will always work. And then there is like, maybe I should show like a way to print it to show how the dynamic array is doing. So dynamic array print. Although here it's the beginning, so we don't have anything to see. So here we can print it at various stages and see the elements are getting put into the array. And yeah, the array is dynamically reallocated in a smart way. That is, so most of these push actually happen instantly. There is just some of them where you have to reallocate the array, and then it's quite slow. And then yeah, just as a bonus, you can very easily implement like the pop to like pop an element at the pop the element at the end of the array. So if the length is zero, it's an error. Otherwise, you just decrease the length and return the last element of the array. And yeah, that's it. So if you printf d like so at the very end and dynamic array pop of da. I think it should be the last one we put, so this number. And yeah, it is. And it decreased the length as well, but the capacity remains the same. So yeah, that's mainly how dynamic array works. This is of course a very basic implementation of them, and there is much more to do, but yeah, I hope you enjoyed it, and it was insightful in the way that it's probably something that you've used for a very long time in various programming languages without really wondering, or maybe wondering how it works, and now you know, it's rather simple and satisfying. So yeah, hopefully you learned something, and yeah. You in the next one.